Hi guys, it's Jessica Hayes. So I've had a few YouTube subscribers request like a jewelry collection kind of video, so that's exactly what I'm going to be doing for you today. I absolutely love collecting different pieces of jewelry, whether it be vintage or from, you know, a weird market, or also I get a lot of my jewelry on Etsy. So I'm gonna go through my little collection for you guys in this video. I'm gonna start off with my rings, which I think has been my longest kind of hoarding obsession so far. This one here is actually my most prized favorite piece. This is actually from Bloodmilk, and my husband bought this for me as an alternative wedding ring. He actually got me this first piece originally, and then just for Christmas he bought me the wedding band to go with it. The designer of Bloodmilk actually did design this ring as more of a wedding piece. So when I'm going out on the weekend and stuff, I actually wear this as a wedding ring instead of my actual wedding ring. So this one is another Bloodmilk ring, and this is another one of my favorite pieces. This was one that I got quite a few years ago as a Christmas present from my husband. He does buy me a lot of Bloodmilk for Christmas. Pretty much he can pick anything from the collection and I will absolutely love it. I think this is called like the Lydia Sparrow Claw ring. And when I first got it, it was really dark gray, but like the patina has worn away quite a bit. And I love how it's made it look even more antique looking. I may as well just do all my Bloodmilk rings while we're on a roll. So this is another Bloodmilk piece, and this is called the Swan Noir ring. You can kind of see it does have like feathers kind of wrapping around the onyx in the center. This one is the only Bloodmilk piece that I've actually bought for myself. This little guy here is like a mini 3D skull that I got from Great Frog London last time I was in LA. This one right here is from Souvenir Jewelry, and this is like a crucifix wraparound style ring. This little ring I actually got off eBay, and when I received it, it was bright, bright silver. It looked like I got it out of a gumball machine. So what I actually did was, if you want to oxidize jewelry and give it kind of that patinaed look really easily, if you get a boiled egg and put it in a plastic bag, a plastic Ziploc bag, and leave it for an hour, 2 hours, it will actually make your jewelry look antiqued instead of really bright silver. I learned that off Google. This little snaky guy is one that I love to layer. It's actually a toe ring that one of my girlfriends bought for me. This ring right here, I love. This is actually a moonstone that I got at a market in Sydney. My mom actually bought it for me. My aunt did tell me, don't buy it because it has a crack through it, and it actually has kind of cracked even more. It's kind of a special piece for me because Mama Bear got it for me. This little hematite ring I got from a vintage stand at a local market. This braided horseshoe ring I actually got from a silversmith called Margaret Cross. She is the wife of Mark Cross, who I was tattooed by when I was in New York. And she was having like a little market stall when we were in New York, so I purchased this one when we were there. I've always wanted a horseshoe ring because my husband actually wears a horseshoe ring as his wedding rings. And this one is just a cool ring. My aunt, she's always worn like really cool silver jewelry. And I remember as a kid, like just always wanting to wear tons of jewelry like she did. So one time I was like, Auntie Mia, I love that ring. She was like, okay, well you can have it. So that's that. Moving on to necklaces. This one that I have on today is another Bloodmilk piece. And this is the Lorraine Cross. This is actually the second time buying this piece because I unfortunately did lose this necklace at a photo shoot downtown Detroit. I was really sad because quite a few great friends pitched in to buy it for me, but I bought it again. This is another Bloodmilk necklace that I have. So it's got the two little skeleton seahorses and a monocle that you can look through to see things bigger if you want. I really love this piece. My mom bought this for me for my birthday, I believe. She, of course, had to pick the least goth piece that Bloodmilk have, but nonetheless, I love it because I wear this one to work quite a bit. For the last of my Bloodmilk pieces, this is the Talon Moon necklace. So these are actually casts of an eagle talon put together to create the shape of a crescent moon. I love layering these two pieces together. One brand that you probably see me wear a few things by is Raw Crystals. This is an Aussie brand. So I love their stuff. They're all like crystally and leathery and like silver hardware. So this is one piece from them that I have that I love. This is also another piece. This was the first piece that I got from them. I just fell in love with this leather kind of choker and quartz crystal. I just think it's really cool. I wear that a lot. This bad boy here is from Unif. This is one of my favorite chokers that I have, just because it is, you know, quite different from everything else that I own. This one I actually got on the ASOS website. This one here too, another one of my favorite pieces. This is a big thorn necklace from a New York designer called Yoela. And this little nameplate one that I have, this is by an Aussie girl, Renee Ruin. My hubby bought me this necklace one time when I was having a bad day. I also have quite a few like collars and harnesses from D'Andre. There's this one, this O-ring collar that I have. And then I also have like this one as well, which is, you know, similar style to that leather choker with the O-ring. I almost forgot about this one. This is a newer one to my collection. This is the mini planchet necklace from Bloodmilk. And that is pretty much it, guys. I actually don't wear earrings very rarely. I have some earrings. I'm more of like a necklace kind of person. I always have been, really. I love like layering necklaces and wearing stacks of rings. All of these indie designers that I have purchased things from Etsy, I'll make sure I leave the details for their stores below in the description box. I haven't included every single piece of my jewelry, so if you ever see me wearing something and you really like it, just ask. I will always tell, unless I've already written it in the comments and you don't read that and you still ask anyways. I won't answer you then. I hope you guys have enjoyed this different kind of style video for me. If you can think of any other weird kind of random videos that you want that aren't makeup related, make sure you leave them in the comments below. Hopefully this makeup that I have on my face, I will actually have a tutorial for soon. I did start to film this look today and then realized that I didn't have the microphone on. And thank you everyone that suggested this video. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.